I'd like to tell you a little bit about elephant teeth. A lot of people often ask questions about the teeth of elephants and especially how many teeth they get in their life. And it's led to a lot of confusion because, you know, of course, all the experts and so on know. But for the average layman, when they see an elephant skull like this, this is the lower jaw of an elephant, they will look at this tooth over here, or this row of teeth, and they'll say, wow, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they've got lots of teeth in their mouth. But in fact, if you look at it from the side, this whole thing is actually just one tooth, and it's these enamel ridges which are bound together with this cementum type material here, and it essentially is coming from a single rootstock. Now, what makes elephants quite different to humans and other mammals is that the teeth don't actually erupt from the bottom, so they're not coming up and pushing the existing tooth out from below. Elephants' teeth actually work by pushing from the back, and you can actually see here how the new tooth is actually pushing through from the back of the jaw. You can see it on this side over here. So the best analogy and the easiest way to think of this is to think of a conveyor belt, where, you know, the new tooth is actually pushing the existing tooth forward as it sort of comes into the mouth. Each successive tooth is ultimately going to be sort of bigger, you know, broader, higher, wider than the tooth before it, because it's based on age and the skull is getting bigger and they're obviously needing to deal with more foodstuffs and so on. So as this existing tooth gets pushed forward, it gets to this sort of fragmentation edge, as I like to call it, in the front here, where you can see here where the tongue and the lower lip is. And then you know, as the pressure of the bite is happening and this tooth moves forwards, it eventually fragments and fractures over here and breaks and falls out onto the ground. So in each of the sides of the mouth, the four quadrants, this is the lower right section, you're in the average elephant, you're going to get six different teeth that move their way into the mouth over a lifespan. There have been, in some cases, a seventh tooth that comes through, sometimes very, very rudimentary or very poorly developed, but it's usually six. So essentially, you know, having been born with the first set when they're very, very, you know, small jawed and small head, the new tooth sort of come into the mouth successively after that at different rates. And you very rarely will just find a single tooth in the mouth. Well, it typically doesn't happen. You're usually going to find part of one in the front and maybe another one and even the third one coming through from the back. So there's always parts of successive sets in each quadrant at the same time. So essentially, looking at the number of teeth that they have, these cheek teeth, if you want to call them that, a lot of people just call them molars. You could actually say that the first three are premolars and the last three are molars. It's totally irrelevant. It's six teeth in each of those quadrants, which equals 24 cheek teeth. And then you see the permanent tusks. Everybody's seen those, but elephants also do have milk tusks. The milk tusks never really protrude beyond the lip line, so you generally don't see them. And what they tend to do is be reabsorbed. They basically form the path for the permanent tusk formation and get the permanent tusk coming through visible at a few years. So the milk tusks are present, although you never see them, so we count them as two milk tusks, two permanent tusks. So you've got 24 cheek teeth and four tusks equals 28 teeth in the average elephant's lifespan.